Hello students, today we are going to discuss about the second part of the fourth module, that is interpretation of cooling curve, and I am your teacher Sudipto Nath, and today we are going to discuss a very brief about it. So cooling curve, what do you understand by the term cooling curve? It is a graphical plot of phases of element on temperature versus time, and the resulting phase during solidification is different for various alloy composition, as we know. And the most common cooling curves are for pure metals, for binary solid solution or alloy, which I have already discussed in the previous video, for eutectic binary alloy, and for off-eutectic binary alloy. Now these are the figures. I have collected it from various sources, from internet that is freely available and from some books. And this is the cooling curve for pure metal. So what you can see, that is from pure liquid state with the reduction in temperature along with time, gradually it will come to a particular solidification temperature, and then when the solidification starts, then until and unless the entire liquid is converted to 100% solid, there is no change in temperature. Okay, so when we are considering the liquid and solid state, then you find out that there is no change in temperature. Okay, after the entire mass is completely solidified, then with the reduction of temperature, the temperature of the entire mass will be reduced. Okay, so on the other hand, we can reverse the curve in the same way. That is, when for a solid material, in case of ice over here, when we are providing some amount of heat energy, so what will happen, that it will start melting, that we know, that only at 0 degree centigrade temperature. So until and unless the entire mass of the ice is completely converted to pure liquid, there will be no change in temperature, although we are putting some heat on it. Then as soon as it is completely converted to pure liquid, then with the application of heat energy, increment of temperature will occur, and that is shown over here. F1 and F0, they are indicating, that is the number of phases present over here. Now, region AB in the previous curve, it represents the liquid state. Solidification starts at B and continue until C. Region CD represent the solid state. Now, application of Gibbs phase rule in the various region, we can explain it in this way. That is the first region, that is region AB, that is from the first stage, we are getting, that is P plus F equal to C plus 1. So P over here, that is a single phase material, so P equal to 1. If F equal to 1 means that only one variable, okay, we are considering, and temperature can be varied without changing the liquid phase of the system. Region BC, which is the flat straight line where the change of phase occurs at constant temperature of 0 degree centigrade in case of pure water and ice. So we are getting P plus F equal to C plus 1, P equal to 2, because there are two different phases. One is ice, one is water. And we are getting from here, that is F equal to 0 from the equation. Thus F equal to 0 means no variable amongst temperature and pressure can be varied without changing the liquid plus solid phase of the system. If the temperature is increased, the metal goes into liquid state, and if the temperature is lower down, it goes into pure solid state. And the last part, that is region CD, where we can get, that is P equal to 1, and F we have to find out, C equal to 1 also. So finally we are going to get F equal to 1 from the equation. It means that only one variable, that is temperature, can be varied without changing solid phase of the system. But it was a very simple one, but more practical in case of metallic or alloy. We are considering this particular type of curve, where we can see, that is from point A to point B, uniform reduction of temperature that occurs, but from point B to point C, the change of phase occurs not at a very constant temperature. Okay, there is a temperature at point B which we call that phase change start temperature, and point C, that is phase change finish temperature. Okay, so after point C, that start, that is the indicator of solid phase, if we lower down the temperature and extract the heat out of the system, then definitely it will become pure solid, and above point B, that is pure liquid towards point A. So over here, region AB represent liquid state and solidification starts at B and continue until point C. Region CD represents solid state. So application of Gibbs phase rule in varieties, in various region, we are going to get region AB, that is P plus F equal to C plus 1. So P equal to 1. So F we have to find out, and C obviously 2. And 2 plus 1 that we are going to get. So F equal to 2 from the equation we are going to get. 2 means that any two variables, that is temperature and composition, can be varied without affecting the liquid phase of the system. Region BC. So over here we are going to get that P equal to 2, obviously, because two different components are there, and C equal to 2, that also are two variables. So over here, from region point B to point C, we are going to get that F equal to 1. It means only one variable, that is temperature, can be varied without much changing in liquid plus solid phase of the system. And the third region, that is the ultimate lower region, in the right hand side we can see, that is from C to D. What exactly is going on? That is P equal to 1 and C equal to 2. So obviously there are two different variables. F equal to 2, it means that two variables, that is temperature and composition, can be varied without affecting the solid phase of the system. Now, one of the most important criteria, that is the criteria number 3 for analyzing the cooling curve for eutectic binary alloy, we can see that there are a number of variables, number of notations, like L plus S1 plus S2 and finally S1 plus S2. What does it mean? L means pure liquid, that is from A to B. From B to C, there is liquid plus two different types of solid it is producing. One is solid 1 and the other one is solid 2. And the third one, that is from C to D, two different types of solids are it is producing, not only one solid, but two different types of solid it is producing. So temperature versus time diagram, if we analyze, we can see that eutectic alloy is the one that undergoes eutectic region during cooling. So eutectic reaction can be stated as I told, that liquid to solid 1 plus solid 2 under constant temperature reduction. Okay, it is reversible. That means that solid 1 plus solid 2, and if we put some temperature in it, so it is producing the liquid phase, pure liquid phase. Thus eutectic alloy, when cooled from two different solid phases, shows typically cooling curve for binary eutectic alloy. And the region AB represent eutectic liquid state. Solidification starts at B and continue until C. The region CD represents solid state containing. Now the application of Gibbs phase rule in various region, for this particular state we get that from region A to B we are getting P plus F equal to C plus 1. So P equal to 1 over here and C equal to 2. What does it mean? It means that obviously F equal to 2 from the equation, that there are two variables, temperature and composition, can be varied without affecting the liquid phase of the system. The second stage, or region 2, that is from B to C, we are getting P plus F equal to C plus 1. So over here P equal to 3 and C equal to 2, it means that obviously if we equate them as per the Gibbs phase rule, we are getting that it is equal to F equal to 0. It means that there are no variables among temperature or pressure or etc. that can be varied without changing the liquid plus solid phase of the system. If the temperature is increased, the metal goes into liquid state, and if the temperature is lowered down, it goes into solid state. Simply just like that. And finally, the last stage, that is region CD, we are going to get, that is P plus F equal to C plus 1. Or P equal to 2, two different components S1 and S2 are over here. And obviously C equal to 2. So we are going to get F equal to 1 from the equation. It means that only one variable, that is temperature, can be varied without changing the solid state of the system. Now the fourth one, it is a bit tricky. That is cooling curve of off-eutectic binary alloy. That is from A to B, pure liquid state. From B to C, it is liquid plus either of the solid state of S1 or S2. Then C to D, it is a constant temperature or isothermal conversion, that is L plus S1 plus S2, and from D to E, that is S1 plus S2. I have explained it over here, that is how off-eutectic alloy with composition less than eutectic composition are called hypoeutectic alloy, and those with composition more than eutectic composition are called hyper-eutectic alloy. Now, some of them are pre-separated before the complete solidification of the state. They are called as pro-eutectic, a particular solid 1, or pro-eutectic solid 2, just like that. Now, you go through these particular articles, and application of the Gibbs phase rule, they are also explained over here. You just go through them. It's not very difficult. Simply just like the previous cases. Now the series of cooling curves, if we put them just like as I have shown over here, then obviously you are going to get an idea that temperature versus time curve, how does it affect, okay, for liquid and solid phases. The second curve, if you see, then there are two different lines. One is black in color, curved one, the top one, and the other one is purple, that is the bottom one. The black one is called as liquidus line, and the bottom one, that is the purple one, is called as solidus line. Everything above the liquidus line is in pure liquid state, and everything below the solidus line is pure solid state. In between, it is a composition or mixture of liquid plus solid solution. Okay, so if we know the temperature, if you know the relative percentage of two or more than two different components of a system over, in this case, because we are considering for binary phase diagram, so let us consider for two different components of the system, then definitely what is the relative percentage of the component and how much is solidified, how much is in liquid state of individual component, that also can be found out using the lever rules principle and so on. So this curve, it is very important from material science point of view, analysis point of view. If you are having any question, you can mail me at this particular email ID and send me to this particular mail. Okay, goodbye for today, goodbye for now. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you are having any doubt, you can contact me.